Good afternoon. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we extend a warm welcome to all on this autumn weekend. To our faithful members and to all of our guests, St. Joseph Parish Family opens its heart in welcome as we share our worship of God and faith. My name is Kelly Scola, and leading us in prayer today is Father Mike. God's word this weekend reminds us that the practice of religion is a matter of the heart. It is all very simple, as the Lord reminds us, to love God and to love our neighbor. This is the way that leads to the kingdom. As we begin our worship, please let us raise our voices in praise of God with a hymn, Praise to the Lord, found in your program. But first, let us rise to greet one another as brothers and sisters in the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
It's a special day today. We have an extra hour added to our day to praise our God, to enjoy the gift of life, and you and I are choosing to use an hour of this day to gather around this table, to worship God, to draw near to the risen Jesus, who speaks to us powerful truth in the gospel this evening. Let's open our hearts to his presence.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God. Glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us, have mercy on us. You take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. Seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the gifts you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. This evening, Chris Cummings is going to begin his ministry among us as a lector, a reader of God's Word. So, Chris, we pray that as you share God's Word with us, the Holy Spirit be in your heart and on your lips. Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to the people, saying, "Fear the Lord your God, and keep throughout the days of your lives all his statutes and commandments, which I enjoin on you, and thus having long life. Hear then, Israel, and be careful to observe them, that you may grow and prosper the more, in keeping with the promise of the Lord, the God of your fathers, to give you a land flowing with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength. Take to heart these words which I enjoin on you today." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I love you, Lord. my strength. O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
My God, my rock of refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Blessed be the Lord, I exclaim, and I am safe from my enemies.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
The Lord lives, and blessed be my rock. Extolled be God, my Savior. You who gave great victories to your king and showed kindness to your anointed.
I love you, Lord, my strength. A
reading from the book of Deuteronomy. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, the Levitical priests were many because they were prevented by death from remaining in office. But Jesus, because he remains forever, has a priesthood that does not pass away. Therefore, he is always able to save those who approach God through him, since he lives forever to make intercession for them. It was fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, innocent, undefiled, separated from sinners, higher than the heavens. He has no need, as did the high priest, to offer sacrifice day after day, first for his own sins and then for those of the people. He did that once for all when he offered himself. For the law appoints men subject to the law appoints men subject to weakness to be high priest. But the word of the oath, which was taken after the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, "Which is the first of all the commandments?" Jesus replied, "The first is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. The scribe said to him, "Well said, teacher, you are right in saying he is one and there is no other than he, and to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices." And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And no one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord.
When I was a young seminarian working my way through college, I had some very interesting summer jobs that not only helped me pay for my education, but also taught me many things about life. Of all the jobs that I had, the summer that I worked at the former Pontiac State Hospital perhaps was the most interesting. I worked as an attendant on a geriatrics ward, helping to care for 45 old men who were wards of the state. That was in an era before group homes and before our sophisticated psychiatric medicines that help people who are in torment or are suffering. These men were either mentally ill, had dementia, or were alcoholics who were either without family or had been alienated completely from their families. It was a difficult job that involved the humblest kind of duties. One day, I remember well, it was particularly difficult because several of the men were agitated, uncooperative, some had soiled themselves, and then there was an old man who another attendant wrestled to the floor in order to shave him, pressing the 82-year-old man's face into the floor so he could use an electric razor to shave him. Well, I was stunned by this, although it wasn't an unusual sight in that ward and in the state hospital during those years, but it shook me up the way that a human being was treated or had to be treated. And so I got emotional about it and I blurted out to another worker on the floor there, a woman that I respected. I said to her, emotionally distraught, I said, "We just have to love these old men." She looked at me and, startled, said to me, "Say what? The state isn't paying me to love these old men." It was a moment of embarrassment for me, and yet one of great insight. It helped shape my attitude in life. Growing up Catholic, the love word had been used a lot, as it is in today's readings, the first reading and our gospel. It was one of the first times in my life when I really began to confront what God's word is commanding us and asking of us. What is it that we're about? What is the most important thing in our lives? In today's Oakland Press, in the forum section, there is an Associated Press article entitled, "A Guide to Issues as the election, a guide to issues at stake in Tuesday's election." It then goes on to list 33 issues and lists them alphabetically, from abortion in Afghanistan to taxes and Wall Street regulations at the end. And it offers a brief commentary and the position of the major parties and candidates on each of those 33 issues. On Tuesday, we're going to have to sort it all out. What is most important? And what we are about as people and a nation when we cast our ballots. In today's gospel, Jesus is at the end of his journey to Jerusalem here in Mark, and he's standing in the temple and the temple precincts, the center of religious power and devotion for the people that he was a part of, the Jewish people. As the story unfolds, within a week, he will be nailed to the cross. It is in the context of the temple and the religious power of his day that the scribe asks Jesus a difficult and important question. Which is the first of all the commandments? In effect, he is asking, what's most important in life? What are we about? It was a popular question asked of rabbis in Jesus' time, learned rabbis. There's a story in the Talmud, the collection of ancient Jewish writings from the first century, that tells a story of a young man, non-Jewish, who promised the great rabbi Shammai that if he could, that he would convert to Judaism if the rabbi could stand on one foot and summarize all that he had to know about the law of Moses, the Torah, the first five books of the Old Testament. The Torah, of course, contains the commandments, not just the Ten Commandments, but 613 do's and don'ts that Moses gives us. And so, the young man said, get it down to what's really important. Stand on one foot and tell me what needs to be taught. And the rabbi Shammai, it said, hit him with a stick and said to him, the depth and breadth of the Torah, God's law, in a few words, this is impossible. So the young man went on to the great Rabbi Hillel, who was alive at Jesus' time, and asked the same thing. And he wisely replied, what is hateful to you, do not do to a fellow human being. This is the entire law. The rest is commentary. Now go learn it. So when Jesus is asked the same question by the scribe in the temple precincts, he answers in a way that pleased even his enemies. He quoted the first reading that we heard from Deuteronomy today, the famous Shema Israel, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is one. You shall love the Lord your God with your whole heart, mind, soul, and strength." Pious Jewish people in Jesus' day prayed that 14 times a day, and some still do. And then Jesus joined that famous prayer with a quote from Leviticus, taken from the law of Moses as well. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The scribe is delighted with Jesus' answer. He said, such love is worth more than all burnt offerings or sacrifices. He echoes the prophets of the Old Testament. The scribe affirms that loving God and every human being is more important than temple sacrifices, than any kind of worship of God. To love God and to love others, that's what's most important. That's what we should be about. And Jesus' affirmation of this truth was a huge challenge to the religious power, the leaders of his day, for he placed love even above worship, the love of God and neighbor. And of course, this led to his death on the cross. Included in Jesus' answer is the truth that the love of God and neighbor is one. It's a unity, one love. It's impossible to separate these two loves. There's no division in love. As St. Bede the Venerable remarked in a homily that he gave in the 8th century, he said, "Neither of these two kinds of love is expressed with full maturity without the other, because God cannot be loved apart from our neighbor, nor our neighbor apart from God." St. Teresa of Avila put it this way, the great Spanish mystic, in her writings, "Though we do not have our Lord with us in bodily presence, we have our neighbor, who for the ends of love and loving service is as good as our Lord himself." As we make our way through life, as we do our work, as we vote, as we show respect to our families, Jesus offers us the way, a clear path, not standing on one foot, but rooted in the twofold commandment to love God and to love our neighbor as ourself. It's what's most important. It's what we're about. Let's profess our love and our belief in God using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Because we love God, we don't fear God. So we bring our prayers confidently this day, our prayers for the world, for the church, and for ourselves.
Let us pray for the church. God, you alone are the Lord, the one true God. May we, the members of your church, love you with all our hearts and serve you. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our nation as the election approaches. Ruler of the universe, guide those who will choose to serve as our officials. With our faith to inform us, may we be faith citizens always conscious of the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our neighbors, our relatives, and friends. Jesus, you love all persons and respect the dignity of the poor. Help us love our neighbors as ourselves. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the elderly and the infirm. Lord of every time and season, lift up those who are burdened with old age or physical illness. We pray especially for Rachel Duff Anderson, Margaret Kubaki, Bonnie McLaughlin, Diane Leitinen, David Puente, Tom Klingler, and Edna Leahy. And for all those who have asked for our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the dead. God, be the rock and refuge of our beloved ones who have died, especially those who were buried through the ministry of our parish this past year. And for Eugene Steck, Joseph Boyven, Tom Hopkins, and Carly Francis, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in a moment of silence for our own personal needs. As we count our blessings in the autumn season, we give our thanks, O God, for the gifts we have received. Help us be generous as good stewards of your gifts. Be with those affected by the recent hurricanes and floods. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of creation, Father of love, we praise and thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus, who is our way, our truth, and our life. Be with us in life's journey with all of its difficulties and problems. Lift us up and hear the prayers that we bring in Jesus' name, who is our Lord, living with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
mercy be asked.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept.
Amen. May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We'll lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifested as the church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he, blessed is he, who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of that Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat his death and drink his cup,
Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the gift of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion together with Benedict, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests and deacons, and with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters, and all who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her husband, the apostles and martyrs, and all the saints. With them we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Let us pray now to the Father, as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer one another some sign of our Lord's peace.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us,
Lamb of God.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Mercy shall be theirs. Blessed are they, the poor of heart. They shall see God. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you. Rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom.
Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's be seated for the announcements.
During the month of November, we remember the dead in a special way. On the banner here in church are the names of those who were buried through the ministry of our parish this past year. Next to the banner, you will find the Book of Remembrance. You may wish to write the names of your deceased loved ones in that book. Today in Marion Hall, you may sign up for the following opportunities. Super Senior Bingo next Sunday. The Woman's Advent by Candlelight Evening on Thursday, November 29th. And the family sign up to light the Advent wreath at our weekend masses during Advent. In Marion Hall, you will also find donation tags on the boughs of blessing tree to help our local food pantry provide food for those in need this Thanksgiving. Those wishing to donate to the Hurricane Sandy relief efforts can access the link to the Archdiocese through the parish website. For those interested in joining Father Mike in a pilgrimage to the Holy Land this April, there will be an informational meeting this Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. in meeting room number 2. Please see the Voice for details about these events. St. Joseph's School's annual Holiday Happenings Craft Show next Saturday and Sunday, November 10th and 11th. And our Orion and Oxford area ecumenical Thanksgiving service here on Sunday, November 18th at 6 p.m.
Thanks, Marion. I acknowledge that Chris Cummings began his ministry as lecturer here today, but we have someone who's began her ministry as cantor here with us, although you're a veteran singer in church, Kathy. But we thank you for sharing your gifts with us here at St. Joseph.
Thank you.
Thank you. And Kathy Keenan. I think you know our deacon, don't you?
I do.
They're husband and wife. So Kathy is Deacon John's wife. Deacon John has family in New York, and they lost power during the hurricane, but they're okay. So they're fine. Good. Anything else to announcers? What I can announce, tonight is the gala event for our school. It's the big fundraiser, the biggest fundraiser of the year. We're celebrating and honoring 60 years, the foundation of St. Joseph's School, 1952. The school has been a part of our mission, of the parish, since for all these 60 years. We're celebrating tonight, raising money to continue to serve our children and to keep the good tradition of our school going. So that's tonight. Anything else to share? Let's stand and pray for God's blessings. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth proclaiming the gospel by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
We are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit.